Hello, today I will describe how to make a spot welder. But the first, short presentation of my tool. Here I am welding batteries for a Makita cordless drill. My spot welder consists of two main parts, transformer from microwave and controller. In this movie I will focus on the controller. I will describe the transformer in another movie. In my first approach I decided to build a controller from SSR relay and Arduino. Unfortunately during welding it triggered a fuse in my house so I abandoned this project and decided to find another solution. I searched AliExpress portal and found a controller named NYJDH22A. I decided to buy it. That controller needs a 9 volts to 12 volts AC power supply. AC not DC. So I also ordered a power supply transformer in the same AliExpress shop. By the way, links to the controller, transformer and other parts are placed in the description under the movie. That controller does double pulse. The first pulse is generally used to displace surface oxides and plating, and the second pulse welds the base materials. This feature also reduces spitting. Controller contains 9 LEDs. First LED means power is on. Second LED is responsible for the foot switch. Third LED is on when the welder is running. In the movie this LED is lighting so long, because I set a very long period of the second pulse. Fourth means the system is ready to use. Next ones are for setting pulses. Fifth and eighth LEDs are responsible for time of the first and the second pulse. Sixth and ninth LEDs are responsible for current of the first and the second pulse. Seventh LED is responsible for delay between two pulses. Time is measured in cycles. One cycle is 20 milliseconds. When the controller is in, ready to use, mode, the actual number of shots is displayed. That number can be cleared by double click. I screwed the controller, wire and the power supply transformer to a plastic holder which I designed and made on my 3D printer. Model of that holder is available on my Thingiverse site. The link is in the description of the movie. Main wire has 3 cores, each core has 2.5 square millimeters. To easily pack the controller I decided to separate the main wire from the controller. So I soldered the connector AMAS MT60 and I isolated it with shrink tape. Because of the thickness of that wire I couldn't use a normal plug. I had to use a special workshop plug. Right now, I think I exaggerated and I could use normal 1.5 square millimeters wire. Please tell me what you think about it in the comment. I didn't cut the wire inside the controller completely. I removed only outer isolation. Then I screwed that wire to the plastic holder. I removed a bit of isolation from the neutral core, blue one, soldered wire to the small power supply transformer and used tape to isolate it. I cut the phase core, brown one, and I soldered one end to PCB. Then I destroyed the female and male AMAS XT60 plugs and I took copper connectors from those plugs. I soldered the second end of the phase core and wire of the small transformer to the female copper connector. I took an additional brown core. I soldered one end to the PCB. On the second end I soldered male connector. I connected the brown core and isolated it with shrink tape. On the end of the controller's wire I soldered 3 flat connectors. 2 cores supply power to the transformer and third one is used to ground the transformer. Because during welding I use 2 hands to hold electrodes I need to use a foot trigger. This foot trigger has 3 wire cores, power, normally closed and normally open. I cut normally closed core because I don't need it and on 2 others cores I put JSTSM plug. I put DuPont connectors to connect the foot trigger wire with the controller.